Welcome to Comic Book Creation Live. This is Kevin Scott Cosme, lead artist, and I'm Anthony Space Windu. We are working on Albatross Junction. There's actually a little drawing I want to show you, Kev. But
we just figured out how to play that music, man, before we went live.
I could start up that music.
Yeah, start up the music, man.
You know what I was also thinking of? This is that really would.
Why do I look so sad, bro?
Are you sad because Albatross still isn't out yet?
I think I'm just sad because I'm 43.
Uh-oh.
I just look sad because my face is just fucking drooping. It's just like, bro, I can't hold up. I can't hold this up no more. Can't hold this up no more. I can't hold this nose and his chin up anymore, bro. Stop eating ho-hos.
Uh-oh.
You got a drawing?
Here we go. Wait, I got a... I want to show you a little something that I... It's just a little stupid sketch, but this is... I think we talked about this vehicle before. Let me switch this camera. Which camera is it? This one.
Hey, what's that? A fucking all-terrain tank turbo Lamborghini?
Like, you know how we have those bikes?
I like this, bro. It's like a crazy looking car with like a looks like a tadpole car in the future with like tank wheels and stuff.
Yeah, so you know these are like the bikes, let's say, behind it, and then this is the more like of a car type situation. Maybe there was like a tandem seating in this or something.
Yeah,
and it's got these tracks, like kind of the same company maybe made these vehicles. I don't know, but. That was just an idea I had for like a scene where they're riding over the snow
mission,
going for something, you know.
Gotta work it out. But it totally looks like a sports car.
Oh, yeah. Well, I was thinking a lot about, you know, sports cars and just how things may have been like before things really went to shit. It's like, you know how during this whole like pandemic thing, it's like, cars were coming out so feverishly, fervently all the time. Different cars, like different models, they were refreshing them all the time. And then this whole pandemic thing hit. I don't know that things are rolling as fast as they were.
Uh-huh.
So, like in Albatross, when on Earth, when things start to really go bad, maybe this is one of the last like ground vehicles that had some style to it before. Things kind of went so bad that, you know, they couldn't really purchase luxury vehicles anymore. They couldn't manufacture them anymore. The Earth was spinning out of control. The sun is gone, you know, the trailer stuff.
Dope.
So.
Dope. Yeah, it could be pretty sick. What color do you see it? Do you see it different colors or do you see it like just all white or all black or like just metal? Like, what do you see it? Just rusty?
Yeah, I kind of see it like at this point, let's say it's all rusty gray and stuff, but when new, it could have been red or something.
Mm-hmm. All right. I like it. I'll log it.
Where is it?
The sun is gone.
That's my favorite part. The sun is gone.
Damn, man. Good. Can you play that again? See if I pick it up on my speaker.
The sun is gone.
You hearing that?
That's crazy. Hey, Patrick McNulty, COVID free. What up, broski? I was asking Mundo about you last week.
Oh,
good to hear,
nice,
man.
Nice.
Good to hear. Good to hear. Said, what's up, bitches? Yo, Patrick is wild, bro.
Thank God. Thank God.
That's good, though, man. That's good to hear.
You got those antibodies, they're building up and they're going to fight off any jerk offs that come around.
Any fucking jerk offs that fuck around, you could cough in their face and be decent to go.
Yeah, Kev, I don't know if you saw. I think you saw it, right? On Instagram, I actually did a third. I showed this. There was another. Let me see if I can lower this camera down a bit. Another thumbnail for page 29. And I was thinking of maybe doing page 30 today.
Yo, I did see this. The only question I had, I didn't want to post to sound like a dickhead, but so where it says clang or whatever you wrote, is that outside or inside?
This right here?
Yeah.
This is what you're saying, there's no sound in space?
Yes, that's the only thing I'm thinking about.
Yeah, well, I don't know. However, we show that this is like rusty, but it's finally like, moving.
How's there going to be a clang in space, bro?
I don't know how there's going to be a clang in space. You got to figure that out as the inker. That's one of your jobs.
I got to change this to fucking rules of the universe. Yes, sir. Much love, man. That's real. That shit is some scary shit. That is some scary shit. I mean, if I was Patrick, I'd be juicing it before I go back to work. But yo, bro, I need another 4 weeks.
Oh, I would tell him it's gonna take till 2021 for me to respond.
I need to get paid till 2020. I need to get paid to 2021 before I go back. Let's not fuck around. I don't want to play with anybody in the office.
Yeah, be like, just for your safety, for everyone's safety, I will have to remain quarantined till
in my house, in my home.
Maybe February 2021. So just to let y'all know.
Stop fucking around.
This email serves to HR as notice of this action. Taking advantage of the
that's funny shit.
The 2019 of the 2020 Act.
Stop playing around.
Okay.
All right. So
share this video that we made here. And this is the one we didn't hear the last time we were drawing. I think this is one I made, number three. Hopefully you can hear this audio.
Yo, air server.
Okay, this is the one you don't like because I start out with Batman.
No, I like the music. You know what? I just don't understand why you're drawing. I'm like, bro, this is Albatross. Fuck back, man. You told me fuck Jim Lee live on fucking YouTube. And then you're going to make a video, start off with Batman, you inconsistent prick. Like, what the fuck? I was like, what? What? Yo, can you hear me? What happened? You stopped talking?
One sec.
Oh, man.
Okay.
Start off with Batman. I don't want to see a speed drawing of Batman after I got fucking yelled at for loving Jim Lee. Look at this. Look at this guy. Giving him all the abs and the pecs. And a... Oh, man. That's loud as hell, bro.
All right, let me lower this more. Does that control it? Does that lower it?
It did. Yeah. It made it lower. Yep. Definitely made it lower.
Okay, cool. I need to pull up the script again. I probably don't even need headphones. You know, it's like, was there echo before when I forgot the headphones? No, but there probably would have been with the music. There probably would have been.
Not really. Any other issues with the Jay Lee, with the whole Jay Lee situation? Nothing else came about.
Like Tom King made like a kind of a fake apology. I don't know if I sent you that video. It was a stupid apology.
It's pretty shitty.
Like your boy Zach made a video that read out the apology. He kind of thought that it was like a legitimate good apology, but I thought it was a shit apology.
It's always gonna be a shit apology once you make such a shitty comment publicly. Yeah. You know what I mean? Like, yeah. Just shut the fuck up. Like, what are you doing?
Trying to like ruin somebody.
Yeah, this is one of my favorite fucking songs because this is the song you use for the intro, isn't it?
Oh yeah, that's true.
Yeah, that's why I love this shit.
Some of those are really short. There was one video though, maybe it was number one or whatever, where it was all like the slower songs, where some of those videos are like, or some of those songs are like 15 minutes long. which is kind of good for drawing, but they're a little bit slow.
Yo, this fucking, I'm not gonna lie, this speed drawing is so distracting. I just keep looking at you drawing Batman and this chick hugging him. This is crazy. Hey, look at what happened. There it goes.
It kind of shows you for 1 second, like the final drawing. The
final, yeah,
when
yeah.
When you do the replay, and then it goes really slow on actually showing you. And you know what? I had to learn because some of the ones I chose 30-second replay, I didn't know about that. That there was like a real like or a, I don't know, like a real time replay in a sense, or a 30-second replay. So some of them I made the mistake of uploading the 30-second replay, like the John.
30 seconds is good though.
Yeah, it was all right.
30 seconds is good though. Hold on. I'm gonna hold on.
Yeah.
What you got? Oh, nice. It looks like we're in GTA now. I feel like I'm in GTA when I see you in that mask. It's like we're about to play survival.
Yeah, I don't care what time of year it is. This mask is creepy, bro.
When was the last time you were on GTA?
Yo, at least like, I don't even know. Beginning of 2019, end of 2018. I don't know. Can you hear me? Wow.
Yeah, I can hear you pretty good. I can hear you better than on a normal night when I can't hear shit.
Get the fuck out of here. For real?
Normally you can't hear anything Kevin says, but. Who are you planning to rob?
Yeah, I gotta start drawing, man.
What are you working on the iPad?
Yeah.
Oh, here we go. I just got to the. Oh, see, page 30 is gonna be fun for me because I remember now it's a full page spread. It's not a 2-page spread. It's a full page spread. I think it's gonna be cool.
Which page is that?
I'll read you the script of it. Page 30, full page spread. We see the spaceship the team came in on has only two figures floating toward it to board it for the journey home. The main part of the page shows the artificial sun they just repaired is shining brightly in a strange colored blue light down to Pike Berg. Mackenzie and Hildebrand have managed to do what the previous six teams could not accomplish and have gotten the satellite started. And the good news is it's fixed to a level better than before, thanks to Hildebrand. When Mackenzie and Hildebrand, now this is like an aside that I'm about to read. We'll deal with this later, but it says when Mackenzie and Hildebrand get back to Earth, the first thing Mackenzie does is to promote Hildebrand to his second in command. She will now oversee the future of Pike Berg's reconstruction and be Mackenzie's technical expert. She's also known to be a physical specimen, having survived the space repair to the satellite and survived that struggle.
Are we giving anybody some like relationships and kids and shit like that? I don't know.
Well, you know, Donovan, Dobbs has that son who's there in Quantum Heights. Donovan's got his whole family.
Yeah, true.
Who else can you think of? You mean, there was those three sisters, like, Paul's dating one of the sisters. One of them died, right? Carrie's, Marie's.
I guess. The real question I'm asking is, does Mackenzie bone Bernadette?
I don't think so. Like, I don't see it that way, but it's open. Like, it's not like a closed story. I haven't like thought of every aspect of it. But the way I saw it was that like Mackenzie is like, let's say he's like 48 to 52 and Bernadette's like flat out 20. So okay. I didn't see it that way, but it could be, you know what I mean? Like, but I didn't see it that way.
I mean, they're both freezing to death. You know what I'm saying? It's like,
yeah, I don't know. I mean, you know, maybe Bernadette's got some other boyfriend, or maybe she's got some boyfriend that she lost, or maybe her whole family died in the war.
Yeah, Bernadette could have her own history going on. Who knows? I think Bernadette is a superstar, though. She's like a fucking, she's a superstar in my head.
I think so, too. I think she could be somebody.
Yeah, she's a killer.
She could be like the Michael Jordan of Pikeburg.
Oh.
Yeah, so
sounds like a Mentos commercial.
I kind of have an idea for what I want to do with that page. So let me switch over.
All right, so I'm either gonna have to go and get the laptop to show what I'm working on the iPad, or just work on it now and show it later.
Talk and draw, and then show it at the end.
Yes, sir.
We don't want to ruin this good relationship we have with the internet right now.
What the fuck? Oh man, yeah. Let me tell you that the highlight of my sad fucking day, right? So you know, my man just passed, right? So we have a chat group talking about him and shit like that.
Mm-hmm.
So my boy who put the chat group together, he's like he's hood, like he's a hood dude, but he moved to VA and he's growing like sunflowers and corn now and shit, right? So my other boy in the chat group, Chris, was like, "Yo, man, that's corny as fuck. Can't believe you growing corn." So everybody was started rolling because we just couldn't believe this dude said corny talking about corn. But he didn't intentionally say corny, try to play with a pun or nothing like that. So all day, everybody been trying to come up with corn puns. And it's been so fucking stupid and ridiculous that it's just hilarious, man. All fuck day. Dumb as fuck. Dumb as fuck, but yo, it's just been funny. Like my homegirl came on, she was like, "Yo, man, I can't deal with this quarantine." Fuck me up. I was like, "Yeah, I can't deal with this shit either."
She had the best one so far, maybe.
Yeah, quarantine. I think won the day, man. Quarantine. You know, with the New York accent, it sounds regular. Like, left a voice note and it sounded normal. I was like, "Yo, I don't. That's why are you laughing? Like, quarantine is quarantine." They were like, "You fucking dickhead, quarantine." I was like, "Yo, I still don't get it." I still don't get what you're talking about, like quarantine. This is wild, man. These three figures in the background that we spoke about last week, they look crazy.
What page are you working on? Hold that up.
Same page, when the Dybbuk was slapping the dude's head off. I remember those three little figures in the bottom.
Show people. I will can you hold it up? I'll make your screen bigger for a second.
Yes, it's going to be hard. It's going to be reflecting a lot.
So, yeah, like, I can see that.
Yeah, those three people over there.
Oh, yeah. Okay. The people in the background. Yeah. And then you got some.
Yeah, it's looking pretty good.
Yeah. You got some loose ends to tie up, probably. And then you can get going on the color, right?
Yeah. Hell yeah. Hey, this is from the day one, this song right here. Yeah.
I had to include the Kevin's favorites.
My shoulder's so hurt, I can't even do a shoulder shimmy. I'm doing one shoulder shimmy.
Is that operation still on schedule?
Yes, sir. On the 28th, man. 28th. Let me tell you how I'm fucking up, though. Before you get the schedule, you got to get, you know, tested for the virus. You got to get a chest x-ray, all this other shit. I haven't done none of that.
And it's only what? It's like 15 days away. I guess you gotta get in there for those things.
Yeah, I gotta fucking hell yeah.
It takes a while to get in for those type of appointments.
I'm acting like I could just walk in and be like, "Okay, Mr. Cosme, no problem." No problem, Kev. Where's Mundo at, man? I want to hear what R2 got to say. Yo, he brings up R2 a lot. It's hilarious.
He's a huge Star Wars fan, right?
No, but it's just funny how it's not, it's like not funny to him. Like, he's like, what do you think, R2? He just fucking brings up the dumb. That's the best ever. What you got planned this week, man?
Now we got a whole week coming up, huh? I've been trying to do so much stuff this weekend that it probably isn't all happening. So I guess the stuff I was supposed to do this weekend, like I took this, I made this video, right? I want the video to be like 17 minutes at the end, and I have like an hour and 11 minutes I'm trying to edit. And I worked like for hours on it already. So I really wanted to get that out for like, I don't know. I thought it would be out today, like before this video went up, but it looks like I'm just hoping now that I can do it before tomorrow morning. So then like tomorrow this week, so then like, so that it could hit like, you know, Monday morning. But, and you know, plus I want to show this guy his lightsaber really bad. And I made this video. I think it's going to come out pretty good, but I just took too much footage like as normal. And I'm trying to edit it out, you know, edit the crap of it out. And then I started taking a video of my friend's lightsaber, and then it ran out of batteries. That got to be really late last night, so I put it on the charger. And then today didn't have time to really make the video. The saber was kind of charging the whole day still. And I need to make that video too. And so I guess all that type of stuff.
That sounds like 17 hours of work, bro. Minimum.
That'll be, you know, after my day job, I'll do that stuff. If I could play some GTA, if I could work out, that'd be...
You've been playing GTA for real?
Like, I literally play, like, probably like 3 days a week for the past couple... Like, at least an hour a time. I posted on Twitch. Space Windu 19.
You're just going online?
Do this mission. Like, there's this mission that they put out like 8 months ago. It's like an update. It's called the Heist. It's called the Grand, or it's called the Diamond Casino Heist. So you have to do all this prep work, like stealing costumes, stealing. Well, like first you have to decide like how you're going to do the heist. There's like three ways to do it. And then when you decide on that, there's so many ways to go about each way, and then you kind of pick like what, like even down to the details of like what gun do you want to bring on the robbery. Then you have to do a mission to like get that type of gun, because like you can't use any of your guns because they're saying like they'll trace the serial number, so, you know, I don't know, like they'll trace it back. So it has to be like unmarked. We have to go get like an Uzi. Like I picked an Uzi. So we have to go get like an and that's a whole mission. And then it's like
to get like the game started though with the heist.
Yeah, it's like it's more like story mode for online now. So then, and this stuff you could do alone, but I was helping Danny do it for his character, and then I realized that you could do some of this alone, so I was doing it for my character alone. But when you actually finally go to do the heist, you do need at least two people, and they recommend two people. So when we do all the prep missions after that's all done, like you had to get the getaway car, you have to do other stuff, and then when all that's done and you're going to do the heist, you need a friend to come online and to help. So that's what I'm aiming for. That's what I've been doing. Like I've been doing like little by little, and I failed. Like I had some good moments on Twitch. I did like three different episodes that turned out good. But this past one that I did like 2 days ago or yesterday was so terrible. I mean, really embarrassed, but I mean, it was like a live stream. What could I do? It was like a situation where I'm trying to steal something for this heist. Just one of the little submissions. The cops catch on because I'm like in the cop station trying to steal something from the cops. The cops catch on to what I'm doing, shoot me down or whatever. I respawn. I have to pick up the stuff that I dropped. and I'm running away from the cops, and I have 4 stars, and they impounded my vehicle, which was like a bulletproof sweet like Lamborghini that I could have gotten away with. And now I'm just like left to try to steal a cop car, steal a different type of car, try to run away. And this went on for 15 minutes, them killing me over and over again. It was really embarrassing. It was really embarrassing. So some of the streams I have, like I look like a hero, and some of them I look like a fucking zero. And like that was one that was bad. But some of them, I mean, I have all these chromed out supercars, and some of the ways I drive is like some of it turns out pretty good. Like there was one contest that comes up when you're just playing online. It says, you know, try to do like a wheelie on the bike, or try to not crash in your vehicle and you try to win the prize for the longest distance not crashing. And I could do that excellently. I'm a fucking king at that. I get like first place. So sometimes I drive awesome, and then sometimes I'm terrible. So
That sounds kind of, just that driving and doing wheelie part sound easy as fuck.
Like, that's the fun stuff. Like, if you're in between stuff and then it comes up as a challenge. Sometimes these challenges come up where I really want to do it. They're like, oh, parachute down and land as close to the ground as you can, and the winner is going to get, you know, like $20,000 or something. I'm like, I could fucking kill people at that, but I'm in the middle of this mission. I can't do it right now. You know what I mean? Yeah. Or something like that. So.
Yeah.
What about you? You're going on vacation this week, huh?
I mean, nothing major. Just going to taking the kids to the Poconos.
What are they going to do there? Catch Lyme disease?
Something like that. Something like that. Get fat. Get bit by ticks.
Look who we got here. Mundo. Yo,
what up?
There he is.
Hanging in there.
What's up, broskies?
Mundo, I need you to, I probably have it in my phone, but it's so deep in my phone I have to look through all the photos. Can you text me like your address again? I want to send you something I found today.
Yeah, sure, dude. No problem.
Yo, your boy Patrick was here, man.
Oh, he was. I missed him.
Yeah, he said he's good. He said he's all good now.
He's awesome. Cured, or he's healed.
Awesome. Thanks be to God, man.
That's really good news.
That is, dude. That does my heart good, dude. That does my heart good with everything.
I'm glad he's not one of those people that have it for a really long time, because if it's if he feels a lot better, I guess it's not one of those situations.
Yeah. That's cool, man. That does my heart good, you know. Everything going on, shoot, that's some good news.
Hell yeah. Hell yeah.
So what you guys working on? Oh, you're working on that bike. That bike.
No, that's just
that's our little recorded music video.
Oh, recorded. Okay, recorded part. Okay.
Kevin is actually not connected to his he said it was gonna be an issue. So I said don't worry about it, just show us at the end what he was doing.
Yeah, exactly. No worries.
If he tries to move to his other location, he will mess everything up, and then he won't be able to say anything.
Yeah. Well, you know it's all good, Kev. No worries.
Yeah, man.
Oh, I'm so disappointed, man. I was playing around with my with the Electrum Sabercraft, the Evo Flex, man. And 2 days it was, you know, working, you know, the sound. I was just working on sounds and hadn't put a blade in it at all or anything like that. Just wanted to check out how the sounds were and kind of get used to the button and stuff. And now all of a sudden, no sound, nothing.
What kind of board is in there?
It's a Titanium 3. Diadem 3, whatever.
I don't know if I know what that is. Is it a NeoPixel?
Yeah, it's a NeoPixel, man.
So even before you put the blade in, it kind of shut down, or it stops working with the sound? Did you ever try the blade?
Yeah, no. And I actually, what I did was I used your chip, man. Mm-hmm. I used your chip with the little acrylic piece of blade stock that I had gotten from some other place. That's,
yeah.
Here in my town. That's from a place here in my town. And I try, and I was gonna try it, and I put it in there, and it lit up for a split second, and that was it. I was like, what the hell? Yeah, I was like, what the hell? So I pulled the card out, and I said, okay, you know what? Maybe I need to just, you know, maybe it needs to update the firmwares. You know, I charged it. I fully charged it. So I said, okay, well, maybe I need to update the firmware, right? So I take the card and I put it in the computer, and I did exactly what they had showed in their training videos to update the firmware. Well, here's the thing. I think this all has to do with that SD card. I think because when I tried to update it, and I did update it, right? It looked like I had the updates in there. And I pulled it out of the computer, put it back in the Saber, and nothing happened. Well, I put it back in the computer, and guess what? The updates weren't there anymore. Neither was the config file, and neither was whatever else was in there, except for the sound fonts. That was it. I was like, what the hell? So I don't know what's going on with that SD card. I'm going to have to email them and find out what's going down with that, you know?
Your experience is like mirroring the way I got into Sabres. Is like I would order something and then like it would either come broken or somehow break. And I'd have to just like, oh my God, now I have to learn how this works so I could fix it, right? Because like I realized like slowly thinking about it, when I would think about it, I'm like, all the things that would have to happen to like for someone else to repair it, I'm like, I just don't think that's feasible, you know, sending it back, doing this, waiting.
Well, here's the thing.
I'm like, I guess I have to do it myself.
Well, here's the thing. I mean, I'm going to have to send it back if I have to, you know, but because I don't want to, I ain't even gotten my blade done, and my blade's not even working right. So I don't want to mess it up, you know, if I can't figure things out.
Right.
So, you know, since I'm so new to this, until I really get a few under my belt, then.
Is that an international shipment or that's a.
Yeah, it's from Canada, dude. It's from Canada.
Oh, okay. That's not as bad as some other places as far as cost usually to ship back.
No. But the thing is, I mean, it's disappointing because it worked for a couple of days and then all of a sudden it's not working completely. You know?
Oh, it worked for a couple of days.
Yeah, and I'm like, what the hell? Yeah, it's shouldn't be like that. But, you know, you pay that amount of money, I mean, and then it comes like that. It just.
How can you live with yourself?
I can't.
Man.
Put down your Star Wars lightsabers. Where's your army? Go! I got it! Me too! Stop.
Mundo was cut out of that commercial because his lightsaber didn't turn on.
Yeah. I'm the outcast. I'm the outcast. So I'm repurposing a board from a portable DVD player right here, and it's got some 330 chips in there, man.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Let's see it. Let me see. Hold it up again. Look what Mundo's working on, Kev. You should be ashamed of yourself.
That looks crazy,
isn't it? I'm gonna pull that heatsink out, man, and repurpose that heatsink big time.
I think Mundo's. Like his bar is like a front for something going on in the back.
There you go.
Something with like electronics going on in the back. I almost got fooled for a second. I looked at the screen and I'm like, Kev, you drawing Donovan? And that's
brother, say, that looks amazing. It's your own work.
Yeah, so I'm going to pull a lot of the stuff off this board, man, and repurpose it. All these capacitors on here, dude. Whew.
Kev, I like this part of the video. It kind of makes sense for, like, comic book. It kind of follows the comic
book. Who's that? Who's this?
This is just, like, some of the page that when I was talking about the evisceration.
Oh, yeah.
That was me, like, planning it out.
I like the stuff you put on that guy's head. It was just like random boxes.
We'll have to add a bunch of stuff like that for their warmth, because we never have them, or I never have them dressed enough for the coldness.
They are underdressed. How dare you?
Their grandma wasn't there to tell them to wear a jacket.
Oh my gosh. Grandma, where are you?
It sounded like you were like a kung fu challenge guy coming to challenge grandma. Like, grandma, where am I?
Oh, what is it? Kung Fu Hustle.
That's my shit. Was a really funny movie, man.
That is my shit.
I was just like laughing my ass off when I saw that. I'm like, man. And you got the lips moving, and then the words come out later. You know, the bad dialogue. Grandma. Grandma comes out with a hairnet, smoking a cigarette, and ready to whoop your ass.
Throwing slippers. She was throwing chanclas at people.
Yeah, there you go. Oh, it was so funny. I saw a kind of like a TikTok, YouTube something video where this grandma took some chunkless, right? She turned them into nunchucks. She like beat the shit out of these guys. Beating the shit out of these guys. Oh man, it was funny as hell. It's like grandma got your back or something like that, whatever it was called.
Yeah, grandma fucked people up with them chunkless, man.
Yeah.
She ain't playing.
Fuck with grandma. Don't fuck with
she
grandma.
Ain't playing.
Hey, Space, you ought to check this out, man. I got this thing off of a Wish. It's like a little fishing gear thing, right?
Mm-hmm.
Just for $1, man. So you paid like $2 for the shipping. But the cool thing about it is that you can put like all your small resistors and
stuff
like that, you know?
I got some little cases like that. You know what I did? They came with the little shrink wrap bits in them, and I kept them, and I have like three of them. And sometimes when I work on a really complicated lightsaber, I use my label maker to label the different compartments of the box. Like when I did the Black Mamba, or when I did like a really important like Graflex or something, and there's a lot of little screws, and I label each little compartment of like what that was for the saber. Cause sometimes, you know, you think you're going to finish it and do the saber in like a weekend or something, but then it ends up taking months sometimes. So
you kind of
need things labeled, because you think you're going to remember, but you're just not, as far as, you know, where every little screw is going to go.
Absolutely. And that's such a good idea, though, to use your little labeler like that, you know? To get organized. Yeah.
What time are you leaving tomorrow, Kev?
Probably be out of here like noon.
All right, so I'll come by with my truck around 1.
The truck around 1.
You have to grab
empty out my place. Empty out all the place.
What were you talking about a while ago, Space, about the getting shot and stuff like that? Is it a game that you're playing?
Oh, GTA, Grand Theft Auto.
Yeah.
I think I was telling Kev about there's a heist that you could do, but you have to do all these missions first to set up for the heist.
Uh-huh.
And I'm broadcasting to Twitch, like all these, like me trying to do all these missions, and I really failed really big time on the previous one I did, but on the few ones leading up to that, I was like a fucking hero. I flew on this like chrome car with a fucking jet on it, and like, or this like jet bike that no one can stop me on, or stuff like that. It's pretty cool.
Yeah, that's awesome. Yeah, I pretty much spend a little bit of time watching movies with the fam today.
Oh, nice. Sounds like a good Sunday.
Yeah. Movies you watch?
We watched Bad Mom's Christmas, and then we, what else did they watch? They watched, I forgot the name of that other movie. Rock something. I wasn't too much into it, but it's like one of those dang love stories, movies, you know, girly movies. But had to do daddy thing, you know. Wifey and this daughter wanted me to watch it with them, so I watched it for a little while.
Watched it with them. Yeah, hell yeah.
Yeah.
You got to, man. You got to.
Yeah. Oh, I finally watched that last Rambo movie. Shoot, man.
How was that? I was thinking about watching that.
Oh, it's good. I can't lie, dude. I got really emotional with it. Simply because I have daughters, and there's a story in there that'll, you know, kind of, you know, if you got daughters, ooh.
It's like a Taken.
Mm-hmm.
Special skills.
Oh, yeah.
He's coming after somebody? Okay.
Yeah, but I won't tell you any more than that, because you got to watch it, man. It really is good. It really is good. I like the way it finished out the saga.
Does he die?
I'll tell you that.
Does he die?
I'm not going to tell you. I'm not going to tell you.
Rambo!
Let's just say he's the shit, dude. He
got to blow. Does he blow anybody up with an arrow?
Oh, I'll say he does justice to the rest of the movies, man. Let's put it that way.
I just gained access to dynamite arrows in Red Dead Redemption 2. In case you wanted to know.
Just in case we want to know. You've been using it?
He's going to go all Rambo on this now.
What's the name of the last movie? Is it just called Rambo?
Last Blood.
Rambo, Last Blood. Yeah.
First Blood, Last Blood. Yeah, I get it. I get it. First Blood was a shit.
Yeah.
It's named after the last amount of money your daughter is going to take from you, Kev, when she's, you know.
Last,
blood.
Last drop of blood, bro.
But that's what's going to happen to me when my daughter goes off to college as well. Shoot.
Man, it's gonna be blood money.
I'm gonna have to go get blood to get some money.
You're gonna have to give your last blood.
That's funny, man. Yeah.
It'll be Mundo. Last blood.
My last blood.
Blah 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 blah
blah blah blah blah blah.
Turn me into a fucking vampire. See what happens. Drain it.
Holy shit. Blah, 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 blah.
I want to be a vampire so I can live forever.
I don't want to live forever. Awesome.
I don't know if I would want to live forever. I think I would live, like to live for a couple of centuries.
Yeah, but if it's the way it is in the movies, where when you live forever, you're kind of young, like when you're, if you're turned as you're young, like, or whatever, like now, like if I was turned now, that's young enough. But I don't, you know, that would be cool because then you could be, you know, 90 or 100 years old and still have the body of like a 40-year-old. But what happens when you really are 90 or 100 and you're like creaking around and like any fall could like break a hip? It's terrible. So I think a vampire is probably a better option.
Fuck that. You gotta go murder somebody and suck their blood, bro.
Not really, because in the TV shows, don't they can get some animal blood will sustain them or something like that a little bit.
Yeah. Well, then you got from the blood bank, you can get the.
Yeah, like when you're, you could go about it in a honest way, Kev. You don't have to be a violent criminal.
Nah, you gotta get it fresh.
You could also get donations. Okay. Like, imagine like the star you could be if you were really a vampire. You could play in a movie a real vampire. You could gain a following. You could have some fans, and then those fans would send you their blood because they'd be like, "Oh my god, he drank my blood!" Like they'd be so happy to have you drink their
and
blood.
And they'll throw a little party. They'll throw a little party just because you drank it.
Yeah, like imagine a real vampire. Like people would really be in love with that. There'd be some like goth people that would just love it, and then be like mega fans.
Oh yeah,
that's a vampire Lestat story.
Yeah. Well, Lestat was the shit though, dude.
He was the shit.
Who was the shit?
Lestat.
Who's that? Who's Lestat?
Remember, he wanted to be a star. He wanted to like to make, let the world know he was a vampire, and he was just a rock star.
I don't know who this is. Are we talking about a real life person? Or...
No, it's not. It's a vampire. What was it?
Like Queen of the Damned.
Queen of the Damned. There you go.
Oh, is that what it was? Yeah. Okay.
Yeah,
Lestat and Morpheus been talked about for a while. Is Marius, not Morpheus, Marius.
Marius, yeah.
And Maury Povich, he could live forever.
Maury Povich.
He's living proof that you can live forever.
You know who else is going to live forever, right?
Who?
Bruce Lee will forever live.
Donovan Cordova. He's gonna live
Bruce
forever.
Lee will live forever. His memory will never fade.
It's fading already.
Nah, dude.
Who's?
Bruce Lee.
Why? How's it fading? Because of that movie that they made him.
No,
look
no.
Like a
teenagers scam? Teenagers don't know who the fuck he is. Not every teenager knows who he is. My sister's kids
we
don't have any idea who
Charles,
he is.
Not them. They're not the future, Kev.
What happened?
Where they aren't the future.
Look how big my cheek is, bro.
What'd you do?
That's a fat cheek.
Well, you got stuffed up in there. You probably ate a beehive today. Why are you up in the, why are you all up in that honey?
Why are you all up in that honey?
He's allergic to bees, so he's climbing up in them beehives.
Damn.
Oh, Kevin getting a glazed donut face, huh? Ooh, that's nice.
That was
the back of the ship, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Look like some bug eyes right there.
I got a good page here. I'm on a roll with these thumbnails. I got a good page here where, like, Kev, it features Dobbs, bro. It features Dobbs.
Dobby Dobson.
Dobby Dobson.
Yo, I want one of those fucking, like, dark forest sandwiches, whatever the hell it was called.
Me too, dude. That place closed down. Wait, are we talking about the place in Long Branch or the place that closed down in Shrewsbury over there? Remember the Mumford's had the California.
Not Mumford's.
Okay, you're talking about Richards. We can make that happen. Yeah. Maybe. Actually, maybe.
No. It wasn't Richards. It was not. It was the other space. It was the spot. I think it was next to Junior's or something. It was just like a regular spot. We used to go there. They had like sailor shit inside. Remember, they had like a ship steering wheel.
Oh, that wasn't over there. That's called Grossman's. That's an ocean.
Grossman's, yeah.
That is a weird place. You think that's still alive? You think that's still there?
I think it's still there because it was local and like the people, like, you know, local people. Like
you could
people.
Get to go, you think? You could get to go,
yeah,
still?
Yeah, man. The people who lived there, they supported that spot.
Yo, so when we're going to meet up for the cookies, I'll either bring it to you, remind me, or, you know, we kind of meet up and get it and come
I'll
over
meet
here.
You there. I'll drive there and meet you there.
Well, I mean, if it's only, well, we got to check first. If it's only to go, we'll bring it to my house, right?
It's definitely only to go.
Oh, okay.
Definitely only to go.
We can bring it to my house.
So check it out. If it's only to go, I'll call the order in, you scoop it up, and then I'll meet you at your crib.
Nice, nice.
There you go. There's a plan.
Yo, did you see me acting like it was a cigarette on the low?
I thought you were sucking on that.
What? Pause. Pause. You were sucking on that. Pause. Pause. Yeah, man. I need one of them fucking sandwiches. I can't lie to you. That sandwich is amazing. Oh my god. Shoot.
How about one of these sandwiches?
That's a good sandwich.
It's amazing. Some cheeks.
Cheek sandwich.
Those are some cheeks, bro. Where you get them cheeks from? Where you get them cheeks from? Where you get them cheeks from?
I got it for a video that I haven't finished making yet. It's
Yeah. You got his little porno stash.
An anti Disney Star Wars video that I'm making.
I feel like you got those from the video where your boy featured your sabers.
No, yeah, that is. Now he has more tasteful stuff. You know, he actually called me just yesterday.
He has more tasteful stuff. Oh, what's up with him?
He's doing a shoot up in Brooklyn on the 15th, and he needs a couple more blades. So I was actually trying to test out this new blade I got just today through DHL, like a couple days late. I don't know why a package came on Sunday, but it did. It's pretty awesome. But then I realized there's like a couple more steps I got to go through to make this thing work for him. So I don't know that I'll be able to get him the new product by the 15th, but I could certainly send him like something I got on hand for his video shoot. But he's going to have some girls out there on some locations in Chinatown, and he's going to film them. So, you know, he said he can't make it to Colombia. He had to cancel all his trips this year, obviously, but he's doing some stuff in New York. So I thought that was a great idea because the last couple of times I was in New York recently, like, it's pretty empty, Kev. I don't know if you noticed.
Yeah, no,
like,
it's crazy.
It's like even less people walking around and stuff. No, it's no, really yeah, weird. It's nuts. So. It's weird to have less people walking around. Like, I understand less cars, but there's a lot less cars, like very few cars, and then like a fourth of the people walking, if not less.
Yeah, that's nuts.
I don't understand how that's possible.
Pretty crazy.
I saw.
Pretty crazy. The hell song is this? Never heard this.
Seems like kind of like a fake
Hootie and the like Blowfish.
Fake, yeah, like, a, like kind of a fake like Creed or something.
You should play that bumper. You should play that bumper, yo. Whoa!
Oh my God.
Yeah!
Sing some more, Kev. We'll get some more people. Remember last time when you sang, some more people came in. Wait, I'm gonna play the bumper.
What the hell was I singing?
Yo, look at Bomag, though. Look at Bomag. Oh my god.
Kev's gonna be the multi-talented artist.
He is. He makes a bunch of like rap songs already. I have no idea. All right, check this out.
You know what's crazy about this setup right now? That the way this is set up right now, I can hear you guys through this headset when you play the bumpers.
Wow.
Which is crazy because when you play the bumpers, it always says your mic is muted right now.
Yeah, isn't that weird? Sometimes I can hear Mundo.
I hear you, man. I hear both of you now.
Are you also hearing
the music? I heard everything.
You're hearing everything. Okay.
I hear the music. I hear everything. And I hear the bumper coming out my loudspeaker, which is crazy.
You got a big problem.
Yo, you know why that's so funny? Because when does that happen, yo? You're laying in bed and you just crack up, just laughing and with such joy. That only happens when you're like 19, bro.
And also, weren't they smoking a cigarette in that scene?
I don't even remember. I remember. I love that.
She's got a cigarette too. Like they
just crack up.
It's totally 1985. They have a cigarette. They're 18.
Yo, all I know is when I was 9 years old, I thought that movie was the shit. Right. Scott Baio was the man.
You grew up.
He was
thinking
Charles
that.
In charge, man. He was Charles in
Charles
charge.
Charles in charge of my day and my night.
And that was kind of tame because that's 10 years after. What's that movie by? What's it called? Get it out. What's that? I'm like losing the whole train of thought. The guy, Woody, not Woody Harrelson. Who's the other guy that like touches young girls? Woody something?
Jesus Christ, bro. Touches young girls? What are you talking about?
Mundo, do you know what I'm talking about? The guy who like got, who had the Asian daughter and then she grew up and he married her.
Oh my God. The New York Jewish dude.
Yeah, what's his
Woody
name?
Allen.
Woody Allen. And what's this like movie that's like Annie something? Annie something? Remember. Anyway, it's a famous movie that he made. It came out in like 75 or 78. And after sex, she smokes a joint. She has like two joints. And then so 10 years later, they have this movie. And after sex, they smoke cigarettes. So they... they stepped it down from weed to cigarettes at least. And then 10 years after that... there wasn't any cigarettes anymore at all.
Bro, I have no idea what point you're making right now, man.
In 1975, after sex, they smoke joints, right? In 1985, after sex, they smoke cigarettes. So you probably saw that movie as a kid and thought, oh, you know, I'm going to have a cigarette, or at least my girlfriend is. You know, after we do it. And then in 1995, in 2000, then they stopped showing all that, right? For the most part.
Yeah, I don't remember. Can't tell you if I kept up with that stuff.
Like, it became a big deal if, like, I think it was, like, Brad Pitt in 7 smoking cigarettes started to become, like, a big deal to people at that
point.
For real? Yeah, like, why is he smoking cigarettes in there? And he was like, I need, like, this character smokes.
Jesus Christ.
It was like an initiation, man. After having sex, you gotta have a fucking cigarette. Damn. the nerve of these fucking people.
Ooh, yeah. Bang, 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 bang.
Is This is when I was drawing the twins in like a an environment that Kevin said it's not green. It's not a green environment.
This was just so crazy to me. I remember we first started came up with the story, and I was like, "Yo, the sun is gone. The sun is gone. It's fucking a frozen earth." And then you just kept drawing people in like tropical climates, fighting naked. I'm like, yo, what are you doing? Like, why? Yeah, it was just weird.
The sun is gone.
I hear you through everything you're doing. It's crazy.
I heard it too. I don't know why. I heard the music as well there.
Yo, it's Shark Week, man. What's happening? Mike Tyson is fighting a shark right now on Shark Week.
It's Albatross Week.
I'm serious. I'm serious, man. It's fucking Shark Week, bro. Yo, this is shaping up to be a card.
Oh, nice. That's not a bloody-ass card.
No, it's not bloody at all unless you use your imagination. Look, check it out.
Oh, nice.
Oh, wow. No, but there's got to be some blood. You got some blood, frozen blood in there.
Yeah, it's going to be in there.
And some spinal cords.
It's looking good. It's looking good.
Any way to connect that at the end of the show that we could see that up on screen, or it's somewhere else you got
to
go?
I mean, I can send it to you, and then can you just throw it up there? No.
That's true. All right, do that at the end. Yeah, do that at the end so we can get that.
Oh, look at Mundo on the screen, looking crazy. Hey, that's the best, man. That's the best. The best. Yo, man, you know, I gotta go through the combo.
I'm gonna put this on like when I'm ready to have somebody killed in the bar, dude.
That sounded so psychotic, bro.
I know, right? I'm like, flip it up, like, flip it up like this, and then
like, you know what?
I'm gonna bring it down like this. I'm gonna say, you dead, motherfucker.
I'm gonna put this on when I'm ready to have somebody killed in the bar.
Yeah. I'll be like, doop, 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 doop. I'm gonna just read the fine print right here.
Okay, yo, I checked out over the past 2 days what I did over the weekend. See, you should ask what I did over the weekend, not what I was gonna do this week.
Yo, what you do over the weekend, man?
It's fun. I watched Transformers War for Cybertron. Fire.
Yo, was I lying though about Optimus Prime talking like a dickhead?
I had to focus on it to realize it, because I watched like an episode and a half before I was like, wait, what was Kevin talking about? Then I started listening and I was like, okay, I think I see it there, but it didn't like, you know how certain things you will hear and another person won't, or whatever, like certain things will annoy you. That didn't really hit me.
Cadence was horrible.
That didn't really hit me so hard. Like,
did you finish it though?
I finished it, yeah, because it seemed to end like right before episode one of Transformers cartoon, right? Is that what happened? Like, it kind of ended like
I have no idea. Well, wait. They ended this series as a prequel to the first Transformers cartoon we saw back in like 85 or whatever it was.
Yes.
Whoa, and it fits. Look at my face.
Yeah, if you went and turned on episode one of season one of Transformers, whatever the
that's crazy, because Willie was like, "Yo, I'm not an Autobot. I'm just doing with a fucking job. Like, stop calling me Autobot." And I was like, "Yo, that's kind of crazy. He's not an Autobot." So I figured it was a prequel.
Willie, you're talking about Bumblebee.
I mean, yeah, Bumblebee. And I was like, "Wait, what? That's fucking. That's crazy. Like, what are they doing?"
They grab hold of that ship that was like crashed into the side of the fucking mountain over here. And you know what they did?
That's crazy.
Like, it's like they drove it through like a fucking Stargate. And that's why they didn't know what the fuck was going on. Cause like they drove it through.
But then
like
that doesn't make sense. That doesn't make sense though. So it but then they fucked up.
I thought it didn't make sense, but I kept thinking about it. And I was like, I think it did make sense.
No, but it doesn't make sense. Because then, I mean, if they were straight on Cybertron before they came to Earth, and that's what they were doing, they wouldn't have been like Mazdas and trucks. They wouldn't have been that.
That's what I thought, like, right at first when I was watching this War for Cybertron show.
That's what they fucked up. They fucked up
a little bit where they should have had it more, like, futuristic.
Yeah, they fucked up because Optimus wasn't a truck before he came.
Right, right. But, like, at least the planes, like, this, like the Starscream and
the planes are different. Yeah, the planes are different.
They were kind of proper. But you're right. Like, they did make it too earthly when it's supposed
to be Cybertronian.
No,
that's what happens when you get a 27-year-old to fucking art.
I know, Kev. That was the mistake that I had to get past when I first turned on the show. When I first got to, like, what they were doing with the show that they were on.
Like, you need a 45-year-old to direct this, bro. Like, come on. Let's keep it real. Not a 27-year-old. He's not going to connect the dots.
I started to realize that when I was in my 20s, Kev, that everyone that was putting out media was also in their 20s and things were starting to change and not be so canonistic, you know, like that you need to really...
Canonistic, yo.
If that's a word. You need to have that continuity. That's a word.
I like it.
Canonistic. There's a good word, though. That's a good word.
It's gotta be true. Boy right here, yo.
It's gotta be true. What's this? A bobblehead?
How fire is this guy right here? Bobblehead, this is Mugos.
Does it speak? If it doesn't speak, it's nothing like R2. Mundo's got an R2 that speaks.
Yeah.
This looks like it glows in the dark, though. That looks pretty cool.
It does glow in the dark.
Yeah. Sorry. R2 doesn't glow in the dark. He just...
That is pretty amazing, though. That's pretty amazing.
That's pretty amazing. He speaks his mind. Right, R2?
I think R2 said, go to IndieGogo and sign up for Albatross Junction.
ASAP,
guys. Come on, guys. Yeah, that's right. ASAP, come on, I already did. Why haven't you? Come join the train, guys. Ride the fun.
Ride the circadian all the way to blood clot. All the way.
It's a blood clot.
Blah 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 blah
blah blah blah blah. Yeah, how crazy is this? I brought this with me camping, right? Last year. It was exactly a year ago. I went camping. I brought this with me. This shit is like a lantern, bro. Like, this is the best ever.
What is this? Let me zoom in on this.
Oh, yeah, that's cool.
Look how many gadgets you got. You're like me when I was 12. Cool, you got every type of gadget.
12. 12-year-old Ant ain't have nothing on me, bro.
I was a king of flashlights. You have no idea. I had lanterns.
Not this. You didn't have lanterns like this, bro. Open it up. And I got the...
Kev's got a lantern and a slinky built in.
That's cool.
You know what I'm saying? Who got that? Who else got that, bro? Are you crazy?
If you got two of those, can you start a heart? Can you restart a heart with that?
Oh, like this?
Clear.
Hell yeah.
Clear. Clear. Clear.
It's a real easy fix. You know, it's an easy fucking fix.
It's an easy fucking fix. Y'all got that. I got the right there.
It was inevitable.
I got skull issues for real, bro. You got me this, bro.
Oh, that's the skull from the Harry Potter world.
Yeah. This is crazy. And what's crazy about this skull is that it's lined with a million skulls. Like, what the fuck? What is going on with this skull, bro? I got it lined with all my caps, bro. What are my caps?
Skull overload.
Skull overload.
Yeah, I was debating on whether to get you
that or this.
I'm skull crazy.
Go crazy. Oh, there you go.
Oh,
this holds pens. Whoa. And I think that other thing I got you holds like drugs, right?
That's pretty crazy, bro. That is pretty crazy. That skull head is pretty crazy. Wow. I'll buy it off you, bro. How much?
I'll go to Harry Potter World and get you one.
I'll buy it off you tomorrow. What's up?
Harry Potter World.
It's like that scene from Game of Thrones when he says he's going to drink from the other guy's skull.
Dude, we were supposed to.
Yo, but he did, though.
Yeah, and he drank from Mormont's skull.
He did drink from Mormont. That was crazy.
Mormont.
Yo, Mormont. He was holding it like this. Yo, Momod. I was like, what the fuck? This is crazy. That was crazy, man. That was crazy.
All of your fucking moments.
Yo, that was crazy. That show was nuts, man. Holy shit. How do you drink from someone's skull?
Very carefully.
32, 30.
Very carefully, or if you don't spill any.
33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 58, 59, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 58, 59, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 58, 59, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 58, 59, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 58, 59, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 58, 59, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 58, 59, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 58, 59, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 58, 59, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 58, 59, 60, 61
Christ. That's a long issue, bro.
That's a big problem. Your issue is less. Let me see. Because I had to I had to rein it in. Like, that's just crazy. I tried to make your issue like 22 pages. I think it ended up being 26.
That's normal. That's kind of normal. Let's see. 20 between 20 and like 25, 30 is normal.
It's just I wanted to get to that one point so that we ended volume one where you wanted to end volume one. And let's see where we're at. 1920 is a double page spread. 21, 22, 23, 24. Oh, 24. End issue two. Perfect. Issue two is 24 pages. 24 plus 40 is a 64 page volume one mega issue.
Yo, I was watching a documentary on Stan Lee at like 3 o'clock this morning. And the front office of early Marvel Comics was banging out a book a day.
What?
Yeah.
Yo, crazy, it was insane, bro. They banged out a book a day. I mean, a comic book a day, like 20 page comic book a day, every day.
Whoa.
That's nutty,
that was after Stan Lee got in.
Yeah, after Stan Lee got in.
That they weren't doing that. They weren't even doing that close to that before he even got in.
Yo, but he had the superstar cast though. It was crazy. And I didn't know his name wasn't Stan Lee. Like, it was Stan Lee something something something. Like, he had three names.
Yeah.
I never knew that. I felt like such a fake fan. I was like, yo, I didn't know that. That he broke it up to Stan Lee. So he had like a stage name back then. You know what I mean? He was like, no, let me break my name up to a stage name. Like, he knew better. Mm-hmm. Pretty sick.
And the crazy thing was that they asked him to cover for this other guy because I think the other guy either left or they fired his ass. Something like that. And they brought him in to cover for that guy. And then it just went from there.
Yeah, and he was over the top. Like, he was so over the top that they started exaggerating all the figures. Like, he started that whole style.
Mm-hmm.
He was a man, yeah, man. He was a man, man.
He brought everything what it is today, you know?
Yeah, he's a man. Nobody else. He's a man.
All right, I think we'll go for like another 20 minutes. So, Kev, maybe in like 15 minutes, you send me that that image that you're working on.
Yo, don't tell me how to live my life, bro. I'm good to go. Y'all say that shit to my wife all the time. She looks at me like, you fucking stupid ass. What are you talking about? She's like, babe, tonight we're going to have hamburgers. Yo, don't tell me how to live my life, man. And she just stops like.
Like, that's going to be a cheeseburger.
Is this the fucking man I married?
You ever get that? Have you ever get that shit where they tell you, like, okay, well, what do you want to eat? And you say, I don't know. And then there's like, well, you got to pick something. But you like, you don't even know what you want to eat, man. Like,
yeah.
How can I tell you what I want to eat when I don't even know myself?
It's We've gotten so far away, like, we've gotten so far away from that discussion, it's not even funny. So, like, we're at the point where I have ingredients to what I'm going to cook. And I'm like, I'm going to make this for myself. Would you like some? And she's like, nah. And I'll just make it happen. I don't even know if the kids are going to have this. It's all fucked
make
up.
For her.
Yeah.
It's all fucked up. Bro, but it's like a hit or miss. Or she'll say, "Oh, like," or she'll say, "Yo, I'm making some like XYZ for me. And she'll make it. She'll be like, would you want some? And then I'll try it. I'm like, this is cool, but you know, this makes me want something else. Like it's just not, it's not how I was brought up. Like when I was brought up, my mother made one thing, set it on the table, say, yo, dinner's ready. Well. We sat down. And if you didn't eat it, she was fucking spoon feed you. Like, you're not gonna eat it? Here, eat that, eat that, eat that, eat that. Like you had no choice. Like, yo, you had no choice. You just had no choice, man. So like my kids have it made. They have like 3 options a night. It's weird. It's
oh
fucking
my
weird.
Gosh. My kids are the same.
It's fucking weird, bro. It's weird. It's weird. It's either they eat something extra healthy, eat something extra unhealthy, or they eat like something neutral. It's wild.
Yeah. Well, my youngest man, I was so impressed with her tonight. And she made like shrimp. She put shrimp on the skillet today. And she made
How old is she? Like, are you talking about like a 12-year-old doing this?
Yeah, she's like 13. She's 13
years. Damn, that's dope.
Yeah.
I wasn't cooking shrimp at 13.
Yeah.
Did she mess it up?
Like, nah, dude. She did good, man. She did good. Nice, raw shrimp, man. Nice. Raw shrimp. She just put it in the pan, sauteed a little bit, threw in some spice in there, and then she threw in some rice in the microwave just so that got some mixed veggies, cooked
nice,
them up.
Man. It's actually a good meal to start with. Shrimp cooks
You're
fast
making
as
me
hell.
Hungry.
Shrimp cooks fast as shit.
Yeah. So what I did was I made some shrimp tacos, bro.
Whoa. Shrimp tacos. Well, I don't eat shrimp. I'm allergic to seafood, so I've never ate shrimp in my life.
Seriously?
I'm allergic to seafood. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Oh, man.
So, God. But I cook them. I cook them once in a very blue moon. I'll cook them for other people.
Wow. I feel for you, bro.
is it that good? I mean, is it that delicious?
It is.
Well,
it
I never
is.
Had it, so I don't know what I'm missing. You know what I'm saying? Like, I have no...
Yeah, yeah. No, it's shrimp is really good, man. I mean, I like seafood, so... It, but for somebody like you who can't eat seafood, oh man, I my heart hurts for you, bro. I mean, I'm not meaning it in a bad way, dude. It's just
no. Because, I'm laughing because it's like I've never had it, so I don't. It's like it means nothing to me. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah.
That's like saying, man, it's like me saying, oh man, I feel so bad for you. You can't breathe seawater, bro. That's you know, swimming under that seawater. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. It's like it doesn't mean anything to you. But like my sister mm-hmm. and my wife are greedy as hell for shrimp, man. Like I would watch them like tear shrimp up like they're it's crazy. Yeah. It's like I go back and forth looking at them like what.
Yeah, it's crazy. That's good. It's that good, man. It's that good. Especially either the fried shrimp or the sauteed shrimp, grilled
coconut shrimp,
coconut shrimp, barbecue shrimp.
They go crazy for coconut shrimp.
My God.
So you made shrimp tacos and they were crazy?
Yeah.
Yeast.
Got some of that shrimp there that my daughter made. Then I threw in some string cheese, some arugula, some spinach, baby spinach, and romaine lettuce.
Yo, you know what I've been doing lately? That's like the easiest and healthiest thing ever. So I've been chopping up jalapenos, right?
Mm-hmm.
I fry them up real quick, just to get that glaze going with the onions, and then mm-hmm. I just take like a tortilla, like a corn tortilla.
Yeah.
I put it on a tray. I put I just put veggies. Like I put asparagus on it. This is gonna sound retarded, but it's good as fuck. I put asparagus on there. I put some I can't even think what the hell I put on it. Some tomatoes, asparagus, mushrooms, sliced up fresh mushrooms. Some cheese now, that like that.
Cooked
that,
or raw?
I put it on. You put it on raw first. Put it on raw, and then just a bunch of like random stuff, like leafy greens and all this other stuff.
Yeah.
And then I squeeze this. There's a place around here that makes fresh hot sauce, like green sauce. Crazy. It's bananas. Yeah. Like it's crazy. I sprinkle that on there and put some honey. Like, and I put that in the toaster oven.
Mm-hmm.
Let it toast up and get hot, and then when it comes out, I drizzle a little bit of honey on it. it's crazy, man. It's crazy.
That sounds
crazy.
Good. That sounds good.
No, it's crazy, man. Because I've been trying to stay away from meat and like just like all this other stuff, trying to eat healthy because, you know, just trying to eat healthy. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
And that's all I've been doing. And it's good, man. It's not exactly like a taco substitute, but it kind of satisfies that urge.
Yeah. Well, unfortunately, I can't stop eating meat. I'm too much of a carnivore.
I had a taco scare a few weeks ago where I was out of sour cream.
Taco scare. A taco scare, bro. I never heard that in my life.
Because when they brought me my taco kit and all my ingredients, they said they were out of sour cream, and I knew they were lying. I think I told you guys that story. But ever since then, I made sure I had sour cream on hand, and I still have sour cream on hand. Cream, so there's no cream. More taco emergencies. Can't deal with that. Gotta have sour cream.
Yo, so before. Stash. Oh, you got a stash. So before I stopped the whole meat thing. What I was doing, mm-hmm. Quarantine started like back in like the end of March, right? Whenever the hell it started. Yeah. It was getting bad. So I would find any leftover meat I had. I would chop it up.
Mm-hmm.
I would put the corn chips on the plate, sprinkle mm-hmm. the chopped up meat on there, throw like the pepper, chopped up peppers, onions, all that other stuff, the sauce on there.
There
the
you
cheese,
go.
throw it in the microwave, melt everything down. Then I would slop the fucking sour cream on. Blah, 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 slop the sour cream on there, spray with the hot sauce. And I was making the craziest nachos ever. I was doing this every day. Then I had to stop because one day I realized that was my breakfast for like 3 days straight.
Oh, wow.
I would wake up. I was like, yo, I'm eating nachos nuts. For breakfast, bro. This is bad. Like, this quarantine is bad. Like, this is going to kill me. I can't do this.
Wait, how are we going to do our like Black Forest turkey sandwiches? You said you're not doing meat?
No. I mean, I'm like 90% meat free. I'll give myself like a day eating meat. You know, I'll give myself like a meat meal because I still crave it. I still want like a steak or like a sandwich here and there, but mm-hmm. I'm just not eating it every day.
Okay.
Yeah, you guys give me a second. I got to let the dog out.
Nah, fuck that. Fuck that. If you're leaving right now, I'm leaving too, bro.
Go ahead, both of you. I'll hold the fort down.
I'm gonna hold the fort down, goddammit.
Yeah, me and R2 will hold the fort down.
Yeah, man. So the only reason I stopped eating meat though, because like every time I eat it, it just fucks me up, man. Like it just fucks me up.
Oh yeah.
I get tired. I can't. I'm just like, I'm fucked up. I'm just fucked up off meat, man. I'm just years of eating meat.
Well, is it because you eat like more than usual, or do you like just because you eat meat, just period?
No, so the honest truth is I have some autoimmunity that's not really clear to any doctor ever.
Mm-hmm.
So when I eat like bread and meat, it's just like it fucks me up. So gluten, I like gluten affects me, and eating mm-hmm. a lot of meat affects me, and I just pass out tired, and I'm just not right. But when I eat just greens and I eat light, I feel fine.
Mm-hmm.
But the fucked up thing is that they don't know what it is. They just know it's an autoimmunity.
Mm-hmm.
I have some autoimmunity thing going on, but they don't know exactly what it is.
Wow.
And that's no fun because they'll say try this drug. I'm like, listen, stop. Don't give me no fucking pill. If you don't even know what it is, you're gonna fucking give me a pill. Like, get out of here.
Yeah. No shit.
I don't like that. Yeah, I don't like that.
No, because then they're just using you for like a fucking guinea pig, dude.
Yeah, man, just to like to fulfill a prescription and get some like type of funding. Like, get out of here, man. Don't just throw don't throw pills at me. I don't like that shit.
Yeah, it's bullshit. Find out the real problem, and then you can fix it. See, so, that's one of the things that bugs me because now these days it's like all these new doctors, they're fucking lazy, dude. They don't want to do their homework. You know,
it's fucked up, man. It's fucked up. It's real fucked up.
They want to see, you know, they want to see their patients. They want to see so many patients in a day and make that fucking money. But yeah, there ain't no money in the fucking cure.
It's messed up. So I went to one doctor. He was like, oh, you have fibromyalgia. Right. So I was like, mm-hmm. get the fuck out of here. So I went to another doctor. He was like, no, mm-hmm. you don't have fibromyalgia. You have rheumatoid arthritis. You have to take this chemo pill. I was like, fuck you. I'm not taking no chemo pill. I went to another doctor. He's like, oh, you have celiac disease. I'm like, get the f-. I'm like, you guys, you don't know shit. You're all fucked up. Like, how every doctor I go to is telling me something different. You know what I mean? I go to another doctor. He's like, you don't have any of that. They don't know what the fuck they're talking about. You have an autoimmunity called, like, I'm like, get the f-. I'm like, you know what? Fuck all of you guys. So I'm just like, you know what? Oh, I'm just got to stop eating bread. I got to stop. I got to stay away from gluten and just keep shit clean.
Yeah.
But you know how hard it is not to eat gluten and butter and fucking, it's ridiculous, man.
Well, see, for me, because I'm diabetic, I have to have the butter, but it's got to be like real butter. It can't be that margarine.
Like Kerrygold butter?
You know, yeah. I mean, kind of like, you know, just as long as it's regular, true, no bullshit, down to earth butter. You know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
No preservatives, none of that bullshit.
No margarine and no plastic and shit.
Yeah, exactly. And then you know, have that like the tortillas that I eat, they're made out of flaxseed and stuff, dude.
So I know what you're talking about. I was gonna start going to that too, but the corn tortillas are like gluten free, but those they fucking break on you, bro. They fucking break on me all the time.
Yeah, there's I'll have to send you the picture of the tortillas that I use, because they're probably, I think, I don't know, you guys got a Costco or something out there? Like,
yeah, hell yeah, we got Costco, BJ's, we got all that shit, Sam's Club.
Okay, y'all got Sam's Club. Okay, they sell that shit, all that shit. They're at Sam's Club, the ones that I get at Sam's Club, okay? And they're called Olay or something like that. Casoles, and they're made out of flaxseed, dude, but they're basically wraps. They're wrap tortillas, right? They're awesome, dude. And they're only four carbs per tortilla. So even if you have two, you ain't gonna feel bad, you ain't gonna feel any of that shit. Yeah.
So exactly. Like, yo, the last thing I got to give up that I'm having a hard time giving up is pizza, man. So like, when I eat like a slice, like two slices, three slices of pizza, you know, I kill them. Then like half hour later, I'm like passing out.
Dude, you can use these to make your own pizza, bro.
Yeah. But it's not, you know, it's not the same. Man. It's not the same as just getting like a fucking square slice.
No. It ain't the same, bro. But I mean,
it's worth it. Yeah, it's worth it though.
I'll tell you. Okay, check this out. See this plate right here? I mean, see how big this plate is? Mm-hmm. That's how big the damn tortillas are, man. I mean, you know, this is only
Is Ant back? Because how the fuck did that? How did you just zoom in like that? Ant did that? Ant's back?
Yeah, I'm here.
I'm like, what the fuck? How'd that happen?
The tortillas are literally that big, bro.
That's big. Yeah, as big as hell.
And I mean, there are only four carbs per tortilla, so you can literally make your own personal pizza out of those.
And if we had my friend Mike here, my karate teacher, he would tell you his impression for Arnold and the tortillas or whatever. Kevin, you know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, little tortilla boy.
Yeah.
Down, they're coming for the tortilla.
But yeah, little dude, I mean, boy. Make burritos and everything like that on your whole meal, man, will probably be about, if maybe, depending on what you use, maybe 12 grams at most.
Nice.
That'll fill you up. And that'll fill you up, man. One tortilla will fill you up, bro.
That's what's up. I need three of those right now.
No. Well, okay, three. Depending on what you put in there. If you were to put that stuff that you were telling me.
Like the veggies? Yeah, I'm good with the veggies. Yeah, I ain't gonna lie.
Okay, and you put it on there? Shoot, you're still looking at maybe, if you eat three of those, you're looking at 16 carbs, maybe?
Not bad. No. Yo, Ed, how's Luke?
He's doing so good now.
The lump is good?
It's really a miracle. Like, what happened is that, you know, he had this surgery, and basically the next day he was so much better than he's been in a while. And like John came over a couple days because John was without power for like the, like they told him it was going to come back on the 11th. His fucking power.
That's what they've been telling everybody. 11th. It's weird.
So like he was here like Wednesday, Thursday, Friday working from here. Cause I have internet. I have power. He needs to do work. He was checking out the dog when he was here and he goes, yo, he goes, the dog is so clear eyed. I was like, yeah, his whole face to me looks brighter. And he goes, yeah, now that you say it, his whole face. And then he's looking at his back legs like the next day. And he's like, you know what? He's standing better. And I was like, holy shit. How did this surgery just make the dog so much like better and happier?
I also some, think like, poison running through his fucking system. Or
yeah. Like he had like a cyst on his back and they took it away. And I swear to God that this thing was like a source of heat as well, because the dog seems cooler. Like he's not hot anymore. Or he was hot for the past 6 months, like fucking just out of breath and hot. They took this thing away and now he's like cooler. He doesn't give a fuck anymore. He's chill. he's happy, smiling, like he wants food all the time again. I swear to God, like, and I was getting so excited. And John goes, listen, he goes, he's still an old dog. He's still 13. I'm like, yeah, I know, but you know, okay. But he's like just doing a lot better. So
I hate those realist fucking remarks though. Like, I know, dickhead. I know he's 13. Fuck, let's enjoy this moment right now. He's better than he was yesterday.
He's happy. Man. He's happy.
And he just seems. And so last night, and like I kind of kept promising him this little walk, but he's got this scar going up and down his back with these stitches. So I was like, you know, trying to hold off, but he seems like he's got all this energy. So I was like, you know, we're gonna go for this walk. So last night at 10 p.m. took him out for this walk. He was so happy and he went where he was like wanting to go further. Then I was trying to pull him down our street again. I was like, listen, you know, I'm thinking too much is too much. Let's just go back to the house. But he wanted to go more. So I was like, I think this was like a really good move.
It's dope. Dope.
That's awesome. That's awesome.
Dope. It's the best, man. That's the base. That's the base. Yo, this is coming out so fucking painterly. It's crazy. It's crazy, man. It's crazy. This is crazy, man.
And you moving along pretty quick on that thing.
Yo, Mundo, you look so fucking serious with that headgear on. It's intimidating, bro.
It's intimidating.
I feel like you're the smartest man in the room. You are the smartest man in the room right now.
Oh, now he looks like a transformer.
Yeah, straight up.
Like one of those helmets that, you know, you could become a transformer.
You look like you're going to save the world, bro.
Save the world,
yeah. Goddammit.
Yeah. Not even close.
Did you see that circuit board he had? He's like making like a missile defense system for Earth.
Right.
Man.
Oh, hey, no. It's the panel for Bernadette. Whatever her name is, trying to fix that.
Bernadette.
Oh, satellite. Yeah, Bernadette.
Yeah.
There we go.
Fixing the satellite. Fixing the satellite, bro.
I like it. Yo, Ed.
Yo.
You got to get that clip from RoboCop. I like it. You got to get that from RoboCop.
Yeah. Oh, there you go. That would be dope.
That's the best. I'd buy that for a dollar. Yeah, the big ass glasses. I'd buy that for a dollar.
I don't know. Do I have the RoboCop DVD? I might. I can get it off Amazon.
You like a YouTube clip, I'm sure. Yeah.
The YouTube clip that I never deleted. That you sent me the email. I never deleted the email. It's the one, and I would love to show it, but it's the one where they can't even put it on YouTube. It had to be on Vimeo. Do you remember, Kev, where RoboCop shoots all the dicks?
Yeah, I do remember that.
It's the best video you will ever see in your entire life, but you can't watch on YouTube. You have to go to like Vimeo or something. It's the best thing ever.
She's that guy between the ladies' dress.
Yeah.
Did you see it? No. Oh my god, this is the greatest.
Somebody made like a spoof off of that.
No, but I made have a spoof the movie.
For that. Where he just kept, but they took that.
No,
scene,
no, no. Kev, can you send it to Muno right now?
They expanded on it, and he keep like he shoot like they show flaccid dicks, and he's shooting them, and they blow it up.
I'm gonna send it to Muno right now. No, Muno, you gotta watch it live with us.
Well, no, I have to.
Muno, you have to watch it. I have to find it.
Ant sent this to me, and I was like, "What?"
No, I didn't send it to you. Didn't you send it to me?
No, I think you sent it to me.
You sent it to me. No, I'm gonna find that. I saved the email. You sent it to me.
You fucking get out of here! You sent it to me.
Maybe you found it for me because maybe I saw it.
This is so long ago. This is so long ago.
Podcast or something.
Yeah, like, somebody
modified.
I found it. Yeah, and I found it. I was like, "Yo, what is this?"
Oh my god, here it is. Oh my god, is this a YouTube video? Oh no, that's something else you sent.
Yeah, if you played on this show was getting banned, bro.
Yeah, this show won't make it. But yeah. No, I want to send it to Mundo so that you can watch it. Let me see. Please tell me I still have this email.
No, it was insane. It was over the top insane. Like, literally, like, dicks exploded. I mean, I don't even feel comfortable saying it, bro. It was too much.
Like, Mundo, it's like, I don't even know what to say.
It's too much. It's too much.
It's like RoboCop targeted everyone's dick and shot their dick. It was
and they showed them exploding though.
Was the worst thing. You actually don't want to see it. Actually, no, you don't want to see it because like sometimes like I'll just think of the dick exploding and it gives me a nightmare. You do not want to get shot in the dick.
Probably give me nightmares too. Shit.
Yeah, because like so it looks legit. Like they use realistic. Like they didn't use CGI. They used like a sack that looked like a dick, and then they shot it, and it exploded. And you're like, "What the fuck?"
Oh damn!
And it's like seven of them exploded.
That hurts already just hearing about it. It hurts.
That's terrible.
All right, I actually didn't save it. I guess because like Kev, I scrolled back to 2010. Wait, let me check my other email.
I mean, I could find it right now, bro.
I know. Wait, maybe you sent it to my personal email. I was checking. I thought you sent it to my work email, but you probably didn't. You said I sent it to my personal email. Come on. Because I know it's on Vimeo. It was on Vimeo. Was it back in 2010?
6 years ago.
Oh, in 20. Damn.
You said it 6 years ago?
It's 6 years ago.
No, please. I even have the first.
I found it. This is terrible. Oh, this is terrible, bro.
Send it to Mundo. Send it to Mundo, please.
It's terrible.
Oh, my God. Send it to Mundo. It's so fucking crazy awful.
Oh my god.
I need Mundo to see it. Isn't it only like 2 minutes? He could see it and then talk about it. Oh my god.
So yo, let me tell you something. This is so bad that the girl that was about to get raped, she's standing there like this. She's like stop. Like stop. This is enough.
She was fucking upset about it.
This is bad, bro. This is bad. Whoever did this is insane, man. This is fucked up, bro. This is fucked up. This is fucked up, man. Jesus Christ.
This is like one of the top three videos. Like on my deathbed, I will remember this video. Like I'll remember this video, Star Wars, and something, Lord of the Rings. Like this is up there.
I'm putting it in the chat so anybody who wants to see it can just like.
No. Okay. Yeah. Do it. Do it.
Could just like watch this, man. Wait, I can't chat publicly. What's happening here?
Put it in the private chat, and I'll put it in the public chat.
Oh, you have to put it in the public chat. Oh my god, this is terrible.
This is crazy, Mundo. If you can click on this, first.
Yo, Mundo, I kind of want to. I kind of want you to watch it just so I can watch.
I
want to
see your face, Mundo. Yeah,
Okay.
Do you have an apparatus? Can you go get another apparatus to watch this on?
Yes, I can get my iPad now. Hold on just a second.
This is terrible, bro. This is terrible. Oh, this is terrible.
And you said
bro.
You send it through my email? You said you
sent
it through my email?
No. You can hit the link right here.
Either the link in the private chat or the public chat.
Now, let me do the public chat.
Oh, this is terrible, man.
Let's see. Okay. Do I really want to open this?
Yeah, you're not ready, bro. You're not ready for this. Nobody's ready for this.
I don't know if I have enough time tonight.
Oh, no. No one else could watch this, bro.
Don't have any children around. don't have anybody around.
No one else.
I know. Watch. That's what I like. That's what
this is terrible. This is like the worst thing you'll ever see in your life.
I haven't even opened it yet.
So make sure you can hear it too, though, because he says funny shit. He's like, hold it right there, criminal. Oh, this is sick. This is crazy. There's my awful laugh.
It's a little maniacal.
Let's see here.
I hope I can hear some of the audio when Mundo plays
okay.
it.
Okay.
I love it. Okay, here we go.
Can you hear it?
Yes, Mundo, I need to see your face. This is going to be the best.
It's going to be horrible, bro. You're not going to sleep tonight.
I probably won't.
Kev, watch Mundo. We don't want to hurt you.
Watch okay, he's just not pulling up right now.
So it's the regular one from the movie first, and then it gets ridiculous.
Right. He's targeting.
That's from the movie. Now it gets stupid.
Yeah, I know that. And then right after that, it's going to get stupid.
Your mind is fucked right now.
Oh! Damn!
he targets anyone around.
Yo, he's like shooting. It's like Frank's exploding, bro.
Keep watching. Ooh. Don't turn away.
Don't turn away. Watch subject.
That's hard not to turn away, dude.
Get that this in your brain.
Hold on.
Do you
want,
can I
share
your
teeth?
Yes,
that's fine.
And do you want?
Okay, that's fine.
This is the worst.
Right in the middle. Right in the middle. My young one comes in. I'm like, I gotta pause this shit.
Oh my god, this is so violent. Oh my god.
Oh.
Yo, it's horrible, bro.
Oh, dude, that is so gross. No, you're right. I may not sleep tonight.
Oh my god, this is one of the top three videos in the world.
World. Oh my god. Oh. Castrated by bullets. Oh my god.
Do not click on that video. Oh my god.
People, Jesus, I'm telling you right now, awful. If you don't want to have nightmares, guys, if you don't want to have nightmares, don't do it.
Yo,
just the memory of it.
Guy? He was too. Oh. He was too disciplined, yo. Like he or she. It might have been a she to sit there and be like, "Yo, let me get this right."
Oh my god!
Holy shit, dude.
That was just wrong. That was just fucking wrong. Oh my God.
That was ridiculous, dude.
Boy.
Yo, I told you.
Yeah. Yeah. Kevin, I about screamed like you just a minute ago. It took every ounce of my being not to scream like that.
Muno, you're a sport. God. Hopefully no child saw any bit of that. It was awful.
No. No kids saw that, so don't worry about that.
That was fucked up though, man. That's just wrong, bro.
Oh my god.
Yeah, I'm gonna send this to you, man.
Okay, that was funny, dude. Watching Muno watch that video. Oh my god. I think that's one of the top three internet videos out there. There's like the honey badger. Yeah, there's the fucking
honey badger's good.
There's the fucking guy with he's got long, beautiful hair. You know, there's like that guy with the news report for the Sasquatch. And then there's the
and
RoboCop
then there's gonna be
video.
Me watching that.
And there's the RoboCop video. Oh,
yeah, well now it's gonna be me on there with my facial expressions watching that shit.
That was the best. That was the best, man. I thoroughly enjoyed that.
Oh. Yeah, well, you can't call them dickheads no more.
Nah, not at all.
Oh my god, Kevin drew something that's completely dark.
What do you mean?
It says the world is dark, so no one should be able to see the artwork.
It's I still have layers to go, man. Sheesh. Layers to go, man.
It's a real easy fix. You know it's an easy fucking fix.
It's an easy fucking fix.
Watch what Kevin came up with, the dark world.
It's fucking dark. There's no sun. What the fuck? There's no sun, man.
All right, this motherfucker has a generator at his feet. Don't forget. Let me share this window. Nice.
That's hot. Get out of here. Fuck off.
That's it.
That is generator. Tough.
A generator at his feet.
That's awesome.
Yeah, so I didn't do the highlights yet. That's looking crazy. Oh, I'm happy with that. You crazy as hell.
Yeah, but don't forget about the generator. Don't forget about the generator.
Yeah, I'm going to put that last with the highlights, man. With the highlights,
yeah.
man.
Yeah, well, I like what you said. That's going to be a card? That'd be a dope
I mean, it
card.
Could be. It could be.
Yeah.
It'd be a dope
Yo,
card.
Look at the action in the swing, bro. That is terrible.
Off with his head. Off with his head.
What's happening? That is terrible, man. Yo, I might make that dude's body bigger, bro, now that I'm looking at it.
Which one? The one in the foreground?
The one that he's slapping the head off of?
Okay, well, I see it as like the head is coming toward us.
So then I should make the...
So that's why
like
the head's
the
a little bigger.
The swipe should be...
Yeah, like you could have some vertex. Of the blood... Yeah, like you could have some of the blood from that swipe like coming toward us a bit, like up, I think, toward the top a bit.
All right.
Maybe you could even make the head a little bigger, maybe. I don't know. It's up to you how you want to handle it. You could make it like it's on the same plane, make the head smaller, make the body bigger. Well, I think the body's got to stay the same size because it shows the size of the dibbick. But if you want to adjust the head or whatever.
All right, nice.
It's looking sick, dude.
Yeah, man. I like this dark shit. Get out of here.
But I would just say, like, since you know, it looks like you put some shadow on the underarm and on the underside of the legs. When I think those would actually be the brightest points because of the generator in between his legs.
Yeah, I'm gonna add the yellow stuff later.
Nice.
That's gonna be the next.
And then, like, this is one of the panels that it's going to be kind of snowing a lot, huh? Like, where it's going to snow more than in
the other. You want me to send you the previous panel? I'll send you the previous panel just that I've been I'm working off. Because the hardest part is keeping it consistent. So I take a snapshot of the previous panel and I leave it small in the corner. So I'm not.
Oh, like, you capture some of the colors. And
I have to. Yeah, I have to.
That's good.
So I'm gonna show you the previous panel. I'm gonna share this with you now, so everyone doesn't think Kev is a dickhead. For like,
I kind of like what you're doing here, actually. Where now that I'm thinking about it, where I think what you're trying to do is almost like accentuate the red blood. So, I'm in agreement with what comes out of Kev's heart.
Here we go. Comes out of my heart, bro. I'm not just doing this haphazardly. I'm fucking fully focused. I'm all in.
He is all in.
All right, check out that page. Check out that page now, sir. Check out that page now, you fuck. Check out that page now, you fuck.
You get it yet?
Boop. Beep, boop. I don't know if you guys can hear my airdrop.
Yo, I did hear some boop boop. I heard some boop boop. I didn't know somebody was doing that shit.
Oh, I thought he was practicing for Betty Boop, you know. Beep, boop, boop, boop.
Holy shit. It didn't come through. You're not going to show it?
Can only click so fast over here. Okay, so this is Jesus the previous Christ. Page.
Yeah. This is the page after. Yeah, the page after.
Okay, so he's jumping away from this scene where there is these glowing embers and just
two
a bloody
sun
wreck.
Satellites in the background.
This I don't think I've seen fully completed yet. This is incredible. Nice job.
That's looking pretty good. You know what I like about this? So let me show you my thinking. My thinking is I kind of wanted to look violent and crazy at first. And then the longer you stare at it, I want the details to kind of like start settling in. Because you know when you're in a dark place. Sorry, all right, it sounds impossible, but I think I'm trying to get there. So you know when you're in like a dark place, right? The lights are on and then they're off. And then your eyes kind of like settle in and you start seeing fucking more detail. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So I'm trying to capture that where like this page looks like a mess, but the more that we just take a minute and you stare at it, all the dead bodies start to pop out at you little by little. And the way I did that was I started coloring over the line art, like the black line art. I fucking
like you added snow to it or something.
Over the black though, over the black. So it's like it kind of breaks up the forms, but it keeps the forms intact enough where you're like, oh, that's a body. Oh, that's a face. Oh, that's the whole body. That's his head here. That's his legs. Oh, that's a fucking arm. It's a leg. You know what I mean? That's what I was thinking of.
Yeah, no, it works perfectly, Kev, because the way I see it, you know, with the your first. Okay, here's the way I'm seeing it. And, you know, at first glance, you see that snow just falling. And like you were saying, you know, the more you look at it and stare at it, then everything else comes into focus with it. And, you know, you start staring at that light a little bit and then the shattered stuff right here. Then you see the bodies come around the light, you know, and then it opens up to all of that all together. After you see the bodies laying around, your eyes move up the further you move up.
Yeah, I didn't want it to scream dead bodies. I wanted you to land on the dead bodies little by little, the more you stare.
Yeah, well, see, here's the thing, because the way I looked at it, and I don't know if anybody else will after I explain this or not, but the way I saw it first is I saw the Dybbuk's first up in the air.
Yeah, Dybbuk burning away, yep.
Yeah, burning away, but with the snow falling. So that's what captures the essence of it first is the snow falling. You see, and the further you go down, then you see everything else down there. You see,
that's what I think too.
I mean, that's like freaking awesome, dude. That is freaking awesome.
Yes.
What's that?
Yes.
Kev, in between the Dybbuk's legs,
Mundo's wife in the house.
Hey, you want to say hi? Say other guys.
Mundo's wife in the house. What's happening?
Her name's Kelly, guys.
Kelly, what's happening?
Kelly, what's happening, man?
Not much. I'm going to bed, person.
You going to bed, person?
Yeah, I just got off the phone
with that. Yeah, Kev, in between the Dybbuk's legs, I think you need to delete a little bit of one of the layers or something so that we could see the sky behind there.
Yeah, the swoosh could get out of there a little bit.
Oh, I see. Okay. Oh, I see. That's part of the swoosh. Okay.
Yeah.
Got it. I mean, and that looks fine, though. The swoosh.
we could do away with that. You're talking about the it looks like the shape of an eye.
Yeah, I just thought I thought it was almost some like a remnant of some layer or something, you know. But
yeah, I can lighten that up easily. Easily, man, easily. Just to let the sky there. Yeah, that'll work. That'll work.
Okay.
That'll work. But yo, that's another reason. That's another reason why I kind of want you to I want to send you these layered files, and then you have your input on visually, you know what I'm saying? And then we kind of like exchange notes before we go to print. Ah, nice. Come on, man. That's fire. That's fire. That's fire.
Yeah, it's cool. And it also looks like, because I can't display both at the same time at this moment, but it looks like from the previous page or the page you did that we just showed, which actually takes place right after this, you have some kind of texture, you know, some kind of painterly effect of a texture that you put on that looks like snow. And when that's all done here, I mean, this is
There's gonna be a lot of layers. This is the first two layers only, and there's usually like 8 layers.
Wow, really, really cool.
Yeah, man. It's gonna be good.
Let me just try to zoom in real quick on this.
You don't zoom in on shit, bro. Don't zoom in at work.
I know it's not working on the screen. All right, but
can't you just can't pinch zoom?
Oh no, wait. Actually, I was zooming in on the wrong file. Let me see if it works. Okay, here we go.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, look at that.
Yo, zoom in on the crotch.
Just like, take that, you bitch.
The bad one. Slapped up. Sounds violent as fuck. Take that, bitch. Nah, that's terrible, man. That's horrible. That's a horrible way to go, let me tell you.
I guess you could have like a little.
Yo, he slapped the spine off of him. Jesus.
I think he took notes from the Predator.
Yeah, he hit him with such violent force.
Force of the Dybbuk. Absolutely. Do not watch the link. I didn't see you put that on it.
Yes, do not watch the link.
Do not watch the link.
This is your only warning.
No, that link is real. That link is very real. Jesus Christ, man. So yeah, man, that was a cool time right there. Got some work done. I'm taking it with me too. So I'm on my downtime when I'm up there, you know, kids sleeping, I'm up, you know, I don't
probably get a little farther before we do the next show on Wednesday.
Yeah, the plus side is that I'm not gonna have any other of my distractions with me, like the paintings and the drawings, nothing. I'm just gonna have this, you know what I mean?
Oh great.
Yeah.
So I'll just chip away at this.
So cool. We will get back together on Wednesday from where you're going to be broadcasting from, and we'll work again on Albatross Junction. Thank you to everybody that tuned in video.
Hold on. This was like a crazy bot, not a body hack, but just a crazy way your body works mechanically. Fuck me up, man. You can.
Wait, you froze.
Wrist.
1 sec.
From this. I froze?
Oh, no. I can hear you now. Okay. Go ahead. My wrist.
Check me out. Turn your wrist from this position to that position. So check me out. So lock your wrist. Don't turn your wrist, right? Put your wrist out straight. Pick it up. Towards your face. Sideways.
What are we doing? He's trying to get us to slap ourselves, man.
No. Then down. That means then straight forward. Now up again. Down. Then over. Your wrist literally went from up to down without lock. And your wrist is locked. You didn't turn your wrist. You know what I'm saying?
I don't know.
Look.
That's trippy.
My wrist is locked. Trippy. My wrist is locked. Yeah, it's trippy. My wrist is locked. So just by doing these movements, my wrist goes, it turns upside down, like it turns, but my wrist is locked. I'm not turning my wrist literally.
Yeah,
Mundo, you understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, I see. I clearly, dude, clearly.
Are you saying something unique to me or something unique to the human body?
So what I'm saying is, your wrist is locked, right, bro? It's locked. Like, lock your wrist. It's not, you're not turning your wrist, but it's going from palms up to palm down just by doing those arm movements. And your wrist is locked.
Locked.
Your wrist is locked.
What do you mean by locked?
Locked meaning you're not turning your wrist. You're not turning your wrist. Lock your wrist in position.
Okay.
So right, you're locked like tensile. Tensile. Your wrist is locked in position. You bring it up, you bring it down to the side here, out, up again, to the side and out. And now it's palms down.
That is crazy.
That's crazy. What that means though.
But what I'm saying is your wrist is like you're not intentionally doing this. You're not just turning your wrist.
Mm-hmm.
So like what's going on mechanically to do that?
I think Wing Chun, but I don't that's all I can think of.
That's pretty crazy. Look, my palm is up and I'm just doing this, but I'm not breaking my wrist. And it works the other way too. It works the other way too.
I don't know. I don't know what I was saying that made you think of this. What about Comic Book Creation Live? Does this?
It's crazy. I'm just lit right now, bro, and I'm being real random. But that's crazy. That's a crazy.
When have we not been random on this?
Got to be random, bro. You got to be random.
Come on.
I guess he's thinking a lot about shoulder movements since he's getting his shoulder work done soon.
But yeah. That's crazy though. That's crazy. I'm not breaking my wrist. I'm not breaking my wrist, bro. I'm not breaking my wrist. I didn't break my wrist at all.
That is interesting.
See, I don't see why it's interesting because I don't understand it.
What are you talking about, bro?
Like to me,
okay.
You just I just look like your arm around.
I just look a dumbass. Oh. I just look a dumbass doing this.
No, it just looks like your wrist is going to a natural maneuver because of the way your shoulder is kind of moving.
Yeah, but I'm not turning my wrist. I'm not doing any of this.
None of the wrist action is moving at all. You're just moving your whole arm.
So like I'm not turning my wrist. Right?
You basically
It's locked.
You're basically going from this position to this position without moving your wrist.
Yeah, so I'm going from palms up to palms down without doing this literally.
Mm. And this is like a good thing.
I don't know if it's a good or a bad thing. It's freaky. Like it's like, why does that happen? Like look. I'm not breaking my wrist, and now my wrist is.
It's not natural. You'd have to turn your wrist for it to stay the way you started.
No, it would.
Look at the way your shoulder's moving.
I'm not breaking my wrist. The only thing that's moving is the elbow.
I'm not turning my wrist at all.
No, what I'm saying is to keep your hand on the same facing up or facing down, you would have to turn your wrist because of the way you're turning your arm to keep it the same.
But I'm not turning my wrist, bro.
I know you're not, but what I'm saying is if you like wanted to keep it palm up, you would have to turn your wrist in like kind of an unnatural way as you're maneuvering your arm that way. It would be like impossible. Impossible.
I can't.
Right?
Yeah.
So it's, I don't know. It's not weird to me. It's just the body mechanics.
That's what it is. It's body mechanics.
That's crazy, bro. That's crazy.
How can you live with yourself?
I can't.
That's crazy, man. It's crazy.
Anyway, I'm going to get Kevin one of these for his birthday.
Use it. Burn fat. Oh, yeah. Them cheeks. Better watch out. RoboCop's coming.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, do not click on that link. All right, so we're going to come back on Wednesday and do our normal comic book Wednesday live show. I hope you'll come back and join us every single Wednesday for Comic Book Creation Live, where we'll be working on Albatross Junction, it seems like, for the next foreseeable future. Go join in on the action on IndieGogo. Just drop us your email. We will keep in touch when we're making some progress on issue number one, probably in like a month or so, and the campaign launches. You'll receive a free poster for signing up early with your email. So that's all it takes. Go to IndieGogo, look up Albatross Junction. How you spell it is on the video right there. And you'll see the comic book with our artwork. Just leave us your email. And anybody got anything to say before we head out?
I'm going to just do a shout out to Pat, man. Glad you're doing better.
Yes, man.
Pat, thanks for coming on the show, dude, and talking with them, you know, before.
Yeah, definitely, Pat. Thank you.
You know, love you, bro.
Glad you're doing well.
Love you a bunch, dude. My brother from another mother. So, brother. And people, make sure, get on IndieGogo. Follow us. You can follow Anthony also on, Space Windu panel? Your Space Windu channel? I need a cigarette, right? And Kevin Cosme, follow him. Everybody, come join the ride on IndieGogo. All you gotta do, drop an email. I already did. You can come and check me out on Albatross Junction. El Mundo's. Come have a drink.
El Mundo's Bar.
You need to make some Mundo in the House shirts, yo, ASAP.
Yeah.
ASAP.
Like hell on full color on the black shirt, I think would be awesome.
Would be fire.
Get that, yeah, man. Get that little the fire and the little hat, you know, to go
with the. And shirt we need some a matchbook from El Mundo's.
Mm. Yeah.
I'm gonna make that happen. Yeah, I'm not lying though. Like, look, let me show you. Ah, that hurt. Ah, that really hurt. Look, I've been collecting matches. See how like matches have been made and all that.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna put some matches together.
There you go.
Oh, okay.
Oh, that's nice. Just fucking. Boy, I'm not. Like, look. Ah, look. Oh, I'm no. Not, you know, I geek out from certain things. But look, I got all these matchbooks I got.
That's awesome, dude.
Got a lot, man. So
that's crazy.
Just seeing what works and what doesn't.
Put them on a high shelf before your little boy climbs up there and gets them.
Nah, he's fucking my little man. So responsible. He's the best. He's always on the system. Like, you can't drink more juice. It's too much. He's no joke. Yo, he's no joke, man. He's a little cop. But look at this old school 1980s matchbook, though.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, there you go. Shop right.
Come on, man.
A lot more for a little less.
Come on, man. Look at this.
Man, RCA. Wow.
Old shit. Old as hell.
Crazy. That's when you knew everybody was smoking.
For real. Everybody had matchbooks. I just think it'd be funny. This is one of my favorite ones, to tell you the truth. Right here. Can you see that?
Oh yeah,
looks like a little Hawaii.
Yeah, a little Hawaii joint. Shop right though. This light is too bright. It's fucking it up.
It's like from the can sale.
This is old though. Yeah. It's from like the '80s. It's from straight eighties. But those letters are fire.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, Sunny Savings.
There you go.
Kyle, healthy beauty.
Yeah,
but that, the palm tree fire, fire, cool.
Dude. You ought to make a painting like that.
That's the real art.
That's the real art, you retard. This man, I've been wilding out, getting all these damn matchbooks. All right, man.
All right, thanks for being here, you guys. We will see you next time. Mundo, thank you. Kevin, thank you.
Thank you. Appreciate being on here, guys.
Always, man. Always. That's the yellow.